Hello, I'm Davide Ponzini, Associate Professor of Urban Planning at Politecnico di Milano. My colleagues Zachary Jones, Nicole De Togni, Stefano Di Vita, and I have organized an international seminar series titled Mega Events in the City, Reflection and Lessons from the Expo, Olympics, and European Capital of Culture. It is a great pleasure for us to present the series today. In this introduction, we will refer to different types of mega events and cultural mega events in particular. Second, to the relevance of reflections and lessons from events in discussing the forthcoming Milano Cortina 2026 Winter Olympics. And finally, we will introduce the speakers and explain how to access our online series. Mega events are perceived as opportunities for urban growth and change, but today the relationship between mega events and hosting cities and regions is changing. For example, the 2024 and 2026 Olympics have witnessed the withdrawal of 4 out of 6 shortlisted cities. The IOC has developed the 2020 agenda in order to promote more sustainable and less costly events. In recent bids for hosting sport mega events, cities have shifted their attention and approach from large budget for delivering self-standing platforms to the reuse of existing infrastructure and venues. From bigness, namely large and decontextualized facilities, to the integration of intervention in the city fabric. A more strict relationship between mega events and the city is indeed an opportunity, but also a threat. In particular, the plans for the Milano Cortina 2026 Winter Olympics envision urban intervention in multiple locations, from the metropolitan core to alpine settings. There is a limited knowledge about new potential balances between mega event planning, delivery, legacy, and urban dynamics at multiple scales. We will derive learnings and lessons across different types of mega events, with particular attention to mega event city nexus. First, in terms of urban governance and legacy. Second, cultural heritage and landscape. Finally, networks and connections at the urban and regional scales. We have invited 6 experts who will discuss mega events and the city from different angles. Zach will explain why cultural mega events are a component of our series. Then Stefano will highlight emerging issues in the planning of 2026 Winter Olympics. And finally, Nicole will introduce the seminars, speakers, and she will explain how you can access the seminars and online discussion. I now turn the microphone to Zachary Jones.
Thank you, Davide. Yes, I am a postdoc researcher at the Politecnico di Milano. I'm a member of the HOMI project, and for the last several years I've been researching particularly these large types of cultural mega events all across Europe.
We thought it was important to include these in our seminar series about mega events, as we found they're an emerging type of event that's been spreading widely, and we thought it was a worthwhile inclusion into this project. One of the most important and well-known of these is the European Capital of Culture. This was founded in 1985, and since that time has been hosted by 60 cities in over 30 countries. It differs slightly from other well-known events like the Olympics, the Expo, or the World Cup, in that it's actually hosted by a city for an entire year. And during that year, the city hosts hundreds or even thousands of events. These events tend to use many existing cultural venues and cultural containers, as well as public spaces, in new and different ways, rather than focusing on large investments in new infrastructure, as is typically associated in the past with events. Again, as Davide mentioned, because of these changes to the Olympics, that we're beginning to recognize, we seemed it was a worthwhile comparison to be able to talk about these types of events as well. Also, as noted, these are now spreading beyond just the European Capital of Culture, as a number of spin-off programs have been inspired around the world, including national programs in the UK with the UK City of Culture. Likewise, there is now the Italian City of Culture, as well as a number of other regional programs across the Latin American world, within Asia, within the Arab, number of Arab countries sharing different cultural titles. Even as of last year, the City of London has a specific borough of culture that will be shared annually by different parts of the city. So this idea of large cultural events has begun to spread globally and at very different scales, very different levels, but we thought was, again, worthwhile to bring in experts and share their experience and knowledge with us as part of this series.
I now will leave the stage to my colleague Stefano so that he can explain more about the situation going on here in Milan and the upcoming Olympics.
Yes, thank you, Zach. I'm Stefano. I am a researcher in urban planning and design here at the Politecnico. As anticipated by Davide and Zach, being the seminar series organized in Milan, we cannot ignore the ongoing planning process of the 2026 Winter Olympics in Milan and Cortina. This mega event was awarded in 2019, and this is one of the reasons why we decided to organize this seminar series. This is an under development process, and for this reason, we at the moment we can only refer to the bidding dossier that was developed by the bidding committee in 2018. And referring to this bidding dossier, you can see on this slide two images. One on the left is a schematic map showing the event locations and sites. In particular, you can recognize the four bubbles corresponding to the four territorial clusters. From left to right, you can see the cluster of Milan in the metropolitan core, and the three on the right, you can see the three clusters on the Alps, the Valtellina, the Val di Fiemme, and the Cortina d'Ampezzo ones. On the right, you can see an image of showing the governance structure of the event as it is defined by the bidding dossier. We try to highlight some opportunities which could be recognized in the bidding dossier of Milan and Cortina 2026, but also some problems, because we think that we can be at the base of our discussion within the different seminars of this series. In general terms, we can say that the bidding dossier referred to the 2020 Olympic agenda goals, which are general but challenging, and at the same time, the goals of sustainability, flexibility, efficiency. But in detail, we can recognize, for instance, the relevance of the multiple mega event locations and sites of the Milan and Cortina bidding dossier. For instance, using existing facilities, planning the post-event reuse of temporary facilities, planning the completion of infrastructure which are currently under construction. But we can recognize at the same time the risk connected to the lack of multiscalar connections, both tangible and intangible, with the surrounding areas of these four territorial clusters, or the areas in between these four territorial clusters, which could be a challenge for our program. The macro-regional scale of the hosting area is an innovative issue in comparison with other Olympic programs. However, we can notice again one of the main risks in comparison also with other case studies or considering the literature on mega events, that is in the specific the extraordinary and the exclusionary governance for the mega event that also in the case of Milan and Cortina is confirmed and we know could be the origin of problems in the event development and in particular in the territorial connection of the event. The bidding dossier focus in particular on the relevance of the legacy of the mega event. Consider a different kind of legacy, for instance, the environment, the society, the economy, the sport industry, tourism, but also urban change processes, mountain areas, development trajectories, broadband connection improvement, and so on. What we can highlight as problematic or as weakness of the Milan and Cortina bidding dossier is again the lack of a specific but also inclusive vision, plan and governance able to consider not only the event but also the longer term post-event and the connection with the area. In general terms, we can highlight the general goal of the international repositioning of maybe the most developed area of our country, Italy, that is one of the general goals of the bidding dossier 2026. However, in this current situation, we cannot ignore in this time also the uncertainties due to the ongoing health emergency that are going to change for sure urban and regional development dynamic and trends, but also mega event issues, goals, and again, development models. These are just some of the issues that we could discuss within our seminar cycle. According to this, I now leave the floor to Nicole De Togni, who is going to detail the program and to present also the invited speakers. So I leave the floor to Nicole. Thank you.
Thank you, Stefano. I'm Nicole De Togni. I'm a research fellow at Politecnico di Milano, dealing with great events in diachronic narratives related to heritage. The seminars will discuss a set of events and their outcomes in terms of possible suggested lesson for Milano Cortina 2026. Our aim is to discuss the comparability of cases, possible generalization, some policy and practice implication, and the contribution of local experts in comparison with the perspective of expert mobilities. We will then involve practitioners, scholars, and experts in the field to discuss the key issue and also the experiences of other cities dealing with different scales and types of event. We planned a series of weekly meetings. We are going to start on April 21st. With the lecture Mega Event and Cultural Policy, Urban Effects, Legacy and Governance by Franco Bianchini from the University of Hull, where he's professor of cultural policy and planning and director of the Cultural Place and Policy Institute. He has been a member of teams preparing the successful bids and also an advisor for the European Capital of Culture, and he published a number of journal articles and reports regarding urban cultural policies in Europe. On April 28, we will host Professor Sampo Ruopila from the University of Turku, discussing the effect of Turku 2011 European Capital of Culture in a long-term perspective. He's Research Director of Urban Studies at the University of Turku and also Director of the Turku Urban Research Program, which is a joint initiatives between the city of Turku and university. And he published as well extensively on urban studies and especially on urban policies. And we had the pleasure in 2016 to add him as a visiting scholar at Politecnico di Milano. On May 5, we will address the topic of the urban legacy of mega events with Beatriz Garcia from the University of Liverpool, discussing the experience of Liverpool 2008 and its impacts 10 years after. So the lecture will be named Liverpool 2008-2018, the impacts of the European Capital of Culture. And Beatriz Garcia is the director of Impact 11, European Capital of Culture Research Program, at the University of Liverpool, and she's also a member of the European Capital of Culture Selection Committee, and also a member of the Culture and Olympic Heritage Commission. On May 12, we will discuss the unsustainability of the Summer Olympic Games with Eva Kassen-Nor from the Michigan State University, where she is Associate Professor of Urban and Transport Planning in the School of Planning, Design and Construction. She holds a joint appointment with the Global Urban Study Program, and she's also Adjunct Associate Professor in Civil and Environmental Engineering, as well as in the Department of Geography, Environment, and Special Sciences. And she published as well on important journals, articles regarding mega events and their legacy. On May 19, we lost Khaled Alawadi from the Khalifa University to explore Dubai urban and regional development and the 2020 Expo project. Khaled Alawadi is assistant professor at Khalifa University, and in 2018, he was also the curator of the United Arab Emirates Pavilion at the Venice Architecture Biennale. He's the director of the Sustainable Critical Infrastructure Urban Research Studio, and his research interests focus on the role of urban form in sustainability, and this studied extensively urban development and its forms in Dubai, Abu Dhabi, and the United Arab Emirates in particular. We will conclude our series with a lecture on May 26, that is a comparison, that will be a comparison by Martin Muller on Winter Olympics, addressing the unsustainabilities of this typology of events, comparing Salt Lake 2002 and Sochi 2014. Martin Muller is a professor of human geography at the University of Lausanne, and is one of the foremost experts, globally speaking, on mega events, hosting, and impact, with a special focus on the Winter Olympic Games. And his work has been featured by great media as the New York Times or the Financial Times, but he also spoke on mega events at the United Nations, at the International Olympics Committee, and on more than 30 other organizations worldwide. Lecture will be available in advance. You can see the link to access freely the lecture on the screen, and you could also use the Twitter account at OMI Project to follow the lecture. We would be glad to host with you an online discussion every day at 5 p.m. after the lecture. To access this online discussion all together, we just ask you to send an email to the two addresses, mine and the one of Zachary Jones, that you can read as well on the screen, just to allow you to participate in the live online discussion. We are really looking forward to our guest lectures and also for the discussion with all of you online. So we hope to see you soon.